Kiana FSU Broncos Sports Network. I am Kiana Smith, and today I'm joined with... FSU Broncos Sports Network. I am Kiana Smith, and today I am joined with
Tysheena Booth.
And we will be commentating your conference matchup between Belva State University Broncos and Shaw University Bears. This is a conference matchup. It is the second doubleheader of the year. We are live in Felton J. Capel Arena. The boys have beaten our Belva State University Broncos have beat Shaw University Bears with the boys matchup, so we're ready to see a good game. Tashina, how you feeling?
I'm feeling pretty good. The environment is very lively with the students coming back to school this week, so
Absolutely. This
is going to be a very good matchup.
All right. And so Belva State University enters the matchup 7-7 overall, 5-2 in the conference. And so far they are 3-0 in division. How do Shaw University match up?
With their overall, they are 6-8. They're 2-4 in the CIAA division, and they are 2-1 within their division. So again, we're looking for a good matchup today.
Last February when the two met, the Broncos actually came out on top. It was 73-62. That was back in February. And then also the Broncos enter on a 5-game winning streak. They have beat John C. Smith. They just did that on January the 6th. On January the 4th, they beat Virginia State. They fell to Bowie State, but they also put away Lincoln and Elizabeth City. It's actually interesting because they both beat Lincoln. The Shaw University Bears beat them 61-53. The Broncos beat them 80-75. So it was a little closer matchup when the Bears played them. So this should be, interesting. They have the ability to beat the same caliber teams.
Yeah.
So I think they probably play a similar pace, and this should be really interesting. I know that Coach Serena King Coleman has a different strategy to the game. She has her players that she depend on, Katisha Hyman, Chantel Bennett, but then she also has the spark plugs that come off the bench, London Thompson, which she actually might be starting because she had an outstanding game when they went up against John C. Smith. She actually had a double-double, 20 points, 10 rebounds. But she has Aminata Johnson, and she has, a depth to a bench that I'm not sure Shaw University has enough to match up to the Broncos. So we should see.
And that's going to give the Broncos the opportunity to keep that intensity going as they substitute players in and out of the game to keep their starters fresh. So that's definitely something to look forward to. The Broncos are averaging about 66 points. Mm-hmm. So, again, this is going to be a really good matchup here.
Alrighty, guys. Well, we are going to go to a very short break. And when we come back, we'll have starting lineups and we'll have keys to the game to talk with you all. We'll be right back after this.
Considering college or wanting to finish your degree? Fayetteville State University is proud to be your smart choice for a high-quality education, nationally ranked degree programs, and an exciting, supportive environment. You will receive an exceptional education at an affordable price. A part of the world-class University of North Carolina system, FSU is an incredible value and a great investment in your future. Visit uncfsu.edu/admissions to arrange a campus tour. We can't wait to meet you.
Spending time together sometimes means doing nothing at all. Holiday Inn, we're there so you can be too.
For the thirsty, for those who hang out in packs, for heroes, for sidekicks, for those who see the glass half empty, for those who see it half full, for those on the right, for those on the left, for those with nicknames, for those with curves, for people that cycle, for people that recycle, for BFFs, for frenemies, for those with style, for lovers, for families, for big families, for everyone.
No.
When you carry out, some things are out of your control. But with Domino's new carryout insurance, we'll replace your pizza if it gets ruined after you leave the store. Carry out large three-topping pizzas for $7.99 every day.
In NCAA.
All right, now we're going to go over the starting lineup for the Shaw University Bears. From number player number zero, Ariana Fleming, junior guard from Newark. Number two, DeJora Howard, senior guard from Orangeburg, South Carolina. Number three, Kaylee Hartman, senior four from Commerce City, Colorado.
At guard, a 5'6 freshman from Maricopa, Arizona.
Number 11, Sydney Callis, Kaylis from Maricopa, Arizona.
Freshman. Wearing number 14.
On guard from Maricopa, Arizona. Number 14, Victoria Swanson, senior from Monmouth, Oregon.
All right, and for our Fayetteville State University Bears, for the starting lineup for tonight's matchup against Shaw University Bears, we have... At guard, the outstanding sophomore from Lumberton, North Carolina, in jersey number 5, is London Thompson. She is averaging 6 points per game, 4 rebounds per game. In jersey number 13, the senior guard standing at 5'10 from Charlotte, North Carolina, Chantel Williams. She's averaging 7.2 points per game, 6.4 rebounds per game, and 3 assists. The spark plug of the team, number 14, Chantel Bennett. She's also a senior guard standing at 5'7 from Sanford, North Carolina, averaging 10 points per game, 2 rebounds, and 1 assist per game. Lights out from behind the arc in jersey number 20, Katisha Hyman, the senior guard, standing at 5'8 from Chakawinity, North Carolina, averaging 18 points per game, 3 rebounds, and 3 assists. And the sophomore forward, standing at 5'11 from Fayetteville, North Carolina, in jersey number 15 is Chanel Davis. She's averaging 3 points per game and 3 rebounds per game. So we got a little bit of a mix-up here for the starting lineup. I think this is the first start for Chanel Davis, second or third start for London Thompson, but London Thompson has certainly earned her her spot right here in the starting lineup. And then, of course, we have the PT peers of the team, Katisha Hyman, Chantel Bennett, and Chantel Williams.
Absolutely. As we get ready for jump ball, Kiana, what are some things that you're looking forward to in today's game?
Well, just looking at the record of Shaw University, in their last 10 games, they've only won 4. And so against bigger teams like Bowie State, Virginia State, Livingstone, and Virginia Union, they weren't able to seal the victory. And I feel like we're a caliber team that's very similar to those teams. We've come up against them. We've actually came away with a W. So I feel like this is a great opportunity for players like Chanel Davis and London Thompson to continue to add to their stats. And I know we've seen last game.
Three-pointer
to get things rolling from Chantel Williams.
Setting his home for the game.
Oh,
sure.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I expect to see that type of play all game long. I mean, it's no reason. It's no reason not to, you know?
Yes. Looks like the Broncos are in a 3-2 defense.
Mm-hmm. But like I was saying, like, last game, Aminata Johnson was just 2 rebounds shy of having a double-double. And I think that a game like this is a place where she could definitely seal those rebounds and have that double-double, you know? And add that to her resume.
Another thing I'm going to be looking for in this game is the offensive, defensive rebound. You know, what team is going to really fight and scrap for that ball? Shaw just got the first offensive rebound of the game. Mm-hmm. And I'm definitely excited to see how we can win that rebound battle.
Ooh, a 3 in return from number 11, Sydney Callis. She's a freshman this year. She's a guard from Arizona. We got a steal. Steal and layup miss from Ariana Fleming. Katisha Hyman came out with the rebound. Eyes up. She's going to kick it out to London Thompson in the corner.
Knockdown shot there.
Good.
3 already.
Oh, wow.
Lady Broncos are really coming out, fighting hard.
Let me find out. The forecast for Fayetteville is raining 3s all afternoon. All right, so we got a little bit of ball movement here from the Bears. They're looking for something. The ball's in the corner.
Victoria Swanson calling for the ball.
Uh-huh, she's going to kick it out.
Kicks it out. Ooh. To her.
Almost, I want to say that Chantel Williams got a piece of that. So that's great defense, hands-up defense from her.
Broncos are going to take the ball out. Chantel Williams inbounds the ball to Chantel Bennett as she gives it back.
No full court pressure, even with basket already being made. That is a difference that we've seen from John C. Smith to Shaw University. I know that they were doing full court presses right after the first basket being made. And they pretty much stayed in that press for the duration of the game. So this should be interesting. Maybe they switch out towards, you know, more intense points to the game, but right now they're just in the zone defense. Chanel Davis is locking down DeJoria Howard. They're going to get an offensive rebound and another shot attempt from Sydney. I believe she was fouled, so she'll go to the free throw line.
Katisha Hyman, that's her first team first. On the line, shooting 2 for the Bears, number 11, Sydney Callis.
And at the free throw line is Sydney Callis shooting the free throw for Shaw University. She makes her first free throw. The score is now 6-4. Broncos leading the way with 7 minutes and 21 seconds left in the game. In the half, in the first quarter, excuse me.
She normally shoots 83% from behind the arc. Ooh. Ah. Eyes up from Chantel Williams. She was trying to catch Chanel Davis cutting down the left side of the lane, but it's going to be a missed pass. It's going to go out of bounds and be Shaw's ball. Now you see Broncos in a full court press or just adding a little bit of pressure. Got some ball rotation going around the horn. A little bit. They're going to try to get it into the paint. It's batted out from Chantel Williams and London Thompson. Katisha Hyman handling the ball. Kicks it out to London. Gets a little discombobulated. A little caught up with number 11, Sydney Callis.
Sydney Callis brings the ball up the court for the Shaw Bears. Ariana
drives. Okay. All right, Katisha Hyman quarterbacking this thing. She's going to back it out. She's getting a screen from Chantel Williams, stopping the top of the key. It's off the back rim. The rebound is Victoria Swanson's. Callis carrying the ball over the half court line. They're going to swing it around to the other wing. It's on the top of the key. It's Swanson has it. She's standing in front of Williams. Chantel Bennett's going to slide over. They've got a little bit of rotational defense going on. Post move from Kaylee Hartman. It's going to be off the mark. That's a defensive board for the Broncos.
London Thompson kicks it to
Miscommunication
there.
So it looked like Chanel Davis probably was there for a few seconds before Katisha realized that she was there. And when she realized it, she stopped looking for the ball. And that's when Katisha Hyman tried to give her the ball. And that's just, you know.
Miscommunication.
Yeah.
Sydney Callis brings the ball up the court. Really patient looking. Pass it off to Toria Swanson. She swings it back to Sydney Callis. Cross the court pass back to Swanson. And Fleming goes for the shot and miss.
Chantel Williams rebounds. Going to give it up to London Thompson down the right side. Nice layup from Thompson. I love that she goes straight into the paint. Not afraid. You know, she didn't even hesitate.
Right. Ready to draw the foul.
Almost lost from Swanson. She's going to kick it back to Callis.
Swanson with the shot.
Ooh.
And make three.
Top of the key. Broncos now trail 2 points. Shaw's up 8-10. That's going to be
offensive foul, number 11. Team second foul.
Media timeout.
Now, one thing I noticed is the Broncos are doing their very best to protect the inside of the paint, making the Bears have to swing the ball from side to side trying to get an opening. But with this 3-2 zone, they're doing a pretty good job of protecting the paint. I just want to see more activity on the rebounds.
Okay.
The Broncos, they average, we're looking at about 36 rebounds per game. So that is definitely something they can get going in this first quarter.
Absolutely. All right, so we've got a little performance from Shaw University. I think that this is actually the first time this year that we've had visiting cheerleaders.
Always fun.
Yep.
Always fun.
Fable State Athletics competes every day with the support of corporate partners. FSU Athletics is proud to partner with Coca-Cola, Domino's, the FSU Foundation Incorporated.
We're going to finish out the remainder of this media timeout, and we'll be right. Well, actually, there it goes. There goes the horn. So we got about 4 minutes and 17 seconds left to play. The Broncos are trailing by 2 points. It's not a lot. It's not very detrimental. I know that we've seen a couple of miscommunication lapses here about twice. And like you were saying, the rebounding, even though I think we're doing a good job of rebounding, especially defensive rebounds. And then here we are in a full court press out of the break, out of the timeout. Callis and Swanson working their way across backcourt.
Keontae Cherry passes the ball off to Victoria Swanson. They get it down in the paint to DeJore Howard. And kicks it out to Tisha Bannister for the shot.
Now, what I think a decent adjustment would be for the zone defense is to make sure they're putting the body on the cutters. I think that they're opening it up and they're starting to work the ball around the horn. And we're just, we're not really like putting a body on the cutters, and so we don't even know that they're there. And by the time they catch it and shoot, it's over. Chantel Williams for a three. Ah, around the rim. The rebound is DeJorius. She gives it up to Swanson. Swanson gives it up to Callis. She's on the wing, and the ball is back in the hands of Callis on the opposite wing. They're swinging the ball pretty fast. It's a shot from the corner from Howard. Score's now 8-15. Bennett kicks it out to Chantel Williams. Back to Bennett. They're going to call it traveling.
Traveling. Once it goes to the Bears.
Another corner shot from DeJoria Howard. It's going to go in and out. It might be her sweet spot. We might have to watch her drive from Jada. She's looking for Chanel. She was being guarded by Victoria Swanson and Dominique Kennedy.
Bears foul on number 25, Dominique.
We have a foul on number 25, Dominique Kennedy. That's her first. And that is the team, Shaw University's first foul of the game.
Got an under-the-basket inbound opportunity. Jada finds Chantel. She's going to look off the open shot. Jada drives baseline. Kicks it out to Chantel. Oof, off the mark. The rebound is Howard's.
I like that look. I like swinging up the ball, getting the best shot opportunity.
Mm-hmm. I don't want us to start relying on those shots, though, just because we started out making those shots at the beginning of the game.
Victoria tries her shot at the three-pointer.
Oh, yeah. Bennett. Ooh, and one for Chantel Bennett.
Chantel Bennett.
She is relentless when it comes to driving to the basket.
Bears foul on number
14.
Foul
is going to be on number 14, Victoria Swanson. That's her first foul. Team second foul for Shaw University.
Into the game for the Bears, number 42.
Rotating into the game, Amani Moxley in jersey number 42. She's a four sophomore this year from Moreno Valley, California.
On the line shooting plus one for the Broncos, number 14, Chantel Bennett.
Basket made from Chantel Bennett. Katisha Hyman is going to rejoin the game and give Jada Faison a rest. Ten seconds backcourt.
Possession goes to the Broncos.
So that press is actually bringing positives out of it. That's great. It's always great when you're working hard because it's not easy to run a full court press and drop back and play defense and then run. You know, so whenever you can get those good plays out of that, like a 10-second violation or a steal out of it, it's always great. Patricia Hyman. Missed three from Shaw University off the hands of Dominique Kennedy. London Thompson driving down the court, finds Chantel Williams. It's kicked to Chantel Bennett and back to Williams. In the corner to London Thompson. Oh, Chantel Bennett has a rebound. Ooh, almost.
Very good awareness by her. Good hands and good timing and getting it up to the basket.
Oh, yeah. Great putback by Chantel Bennett.
Good steal.
Nice.
London Thompson with the steal, kicks it out to Chantel Bennett and
Chantel Bennett.
Quick 6 points from Chantel Bennett. You guys, I'm telling you, she is a spark plug. And just like that, the score is now 14-15. About just under 30 seconds left to play. Victoria Swanson driving. She finds Moxley. Air ball from Moxley. She tries to kick it out. It swung. Missed layup. Rebound to Chanel Davis. Chantel Williams tried to give a lead pass up to Chantel Bennett. It's too much.
She has a strong arm. She is very strong.
And part of that is excitement, too. Like, ooh, yeah. Here she go, you know.
Victoria Swanson with the ball, passes it back to number four, Tyra Sinclair.
3 seconds.
she goes for the shot. Miss.
Way off the mark, Tyra Sinclair. But at least she was aware and seen that the clock was winding down and put something up. Now 15-15 is tied up. We are about to go into the second quarter, guys. We're going to go head into our timeouts and our respective benches and strategize what we need to do in this next quarter of play. We'll be right back after this.
Visit www.cpat.org to find out more.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, so we're going to have Mr. Will Combo, also known as Mr. FSU. Okay, Mr. Combo, so we have 30 seconds to make layup, throw, corner, layup, throw, three, okay? Start anywhere. You got to make all three in 30 seconds. Ready? 3, 2, 1, go. The box. There you go, Mr. Evans. At the free throw. 17 seconds. Nice shot. Nice shot. 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Oh. One more shot.
Second quarter, Bears ball.
All right, and we are back as Ariana, Sydney Callis passes the ball off to Tyra Sinclair. Sinclair passes back to Callis, back to Sinclair, and into the paint from Ariana Fleming for the shot.
DJ Howard.
Sorry, that was DJ Howard for the shot. Kitsy Shaheim with the ball, top of the key, kicks it to London Thompson, into the paint for Chantel Bennett with the...
Ooh, nice rebound, Aminata. You got to finish those. London Thompson on the wing. I'm trying to see what that call was. Was it a... Oh, okay. There was some mix-up with the shot clock time. London Thompson has it on the sideline. Chantel Williams going to get the ball. Ooh, a block from DJ Howard. I'm not sure if that was a shot block or a pass block. But anyways, now that we're aware of that, we got to put up some shot fakes.
That would have been a good shot. Pump fake right there.
Uh-huh. Aminata going to work in the paint.
Good awareness of the time.
Mm-hmm. Callis. Quarterback in for Shaw University. It's in the corner, and it's a three opportunity or attempt from Dominique Kennedy. It's no good. Chantel Williams and Chantel Bennett. Ooh, and one.
For Chantel.
Is going to be on number four, Tyra Sinclair.
Back into the game for the Bears, number 14, Victoria Swanson. On the line, shooting plus one for the Broncos. Jada Mason returns to the game. Chantel Bennett has one shot.
And she makes her shot. The score is now 18-17. Broncos leading the way. Sydney Callis brings the ball up the court for the Bears. Looking to set something up. Good, good.
Possession remains to the Bears.
Almost still by Chantel Bennett. Swanson's going to inbound the ball to Sydney Callis. Swanson kicks it back. DJ's calling for the ball in the paint. Swanson with the shot and miss. Offensive rebound by Beyonce Cherry.
Now, you mentioned that you wanted to see more rebounding. That was, what, two possessions?
Mm-hmm. We have to get on the offensive board. We got to make sure they're blocking out. They are still with the ball. Swanson calling for the ball to the top of the key to Cherry. Swing ball. Sydney Callis couldn't hold on to it that time. Broncos will inbound the ball.
Into the game for the Bears, number zero, Ariana Fleming.
On the court for the Broncos, we have in jersey number 11, Jada Faison, 13, Chantel Williams, 14, Chantel Bennett, 32, Aminata Johnson, and 20, Katisha Hyman. And for the Bears, we've got number 10, Keontae Cherry, number 14, Victoria Swanson. We have number 0, Ariana Fleming, number 2, DJ Howard, and number 11, Sydney Callis.
3-second violation. Possession goes to the Bears.
So that 3-second violation is actually going to switch possessions. It's going to be the Bears' ball. Victoria Swanson and Callis still working their way up against this press. Jada Faison and Chantel Bennett running point. Got some pressure put on. Oh, we got a steal from Katisha Hyman. She finds Chantel Bennett. Chantel Williams and back to Bennett for the layup.
That was great ball movement. Very good patience. And defense.
Ooh, nice block from Katisha Hyman. Defensive board from Aminata Johnson. Chantel Williams carrying the basketball. Stop and pop from her right in front of the foul line. Rebound from Aminata Johnson and a nice putback. Oh, wow. Broncos going off. This is has to be a nice little at least 4-point run. Swanson slowing things down. She's going to pass it off to Callis. Back on the wing, Swanson. Swung around from the elbow. Swanson with the 3-point attempt. It's no good. Aminata Johnson has the rebound. Williams to Hyman. And Hyman misses the layup, chases down her rebound.
Very rare.
Callis holding the basketball close around the half court line until Swanson cuts through the paint and she's on the wing. DJ Howard faces up against Aminata. Off the mark is Jada Faison's rebound. Eyes up, she's looking for Chantel Bennett. She keeps it herself, drives into the basket, and a foul is called.
Bears foul on number 2.
DJ Howard, that's her third foul, team second.
To the game for the Broncos, number 5, Lundin Thompson, also in for the Bears, number 3,
Kaylee Hartman. Lundin Thompson and Williams almost intercepted by Ariana Fleming.
Balls out of bounds, possession goes to the Bears.
They're going to call it off on White. It's still going to be Shaw Bears' possession. Couple swings around the horn from the Bears. Swanson has it on the wing. Fleming at the top of the key. Kaylee Callis, Fleming driving, blocked by Lundin Thompson. Katisha Hyman has it down the sideline. Eyes up, Broncos on the way. Williams on the wing. Gonna give it up back to Hyman. Good. One, two, three.
For Katisha Hyman.
She makes it look so easy.
Yeah. You notice she shoots with a lot of power, too, so the ball goes straight down into the hoop.
Mm-hmm.
Good ball movement from the Bears.
Uh-huh. They find Fleming. Uh-oh. Stole. Katisha Hyman.
Good drive, good awareness.
Nice. Never even allowed Victoria Swanson to know which side she was going to even be able to play defense.
And the Broncos are on a little run here. Playing some pretty good defense. Mm-hmm. Definitely getting that ball back in their possession.
Yep, they are now up 10 points, 27-17. Here in Felton J. Cable Arena for the second doubleheader of the year. Their last win was about 30 points over John C. Smith. So they're really getting into their rhythm here. Moxley in the corner is no good. It's a rebound from London Thompson. Williams finds facing. Kick back to Katisha and from deep. Oh, almost off the front of the rim. It's a rebound for Callis.
Swanson thought about it, kicks it back to Sydney Callis.
She's trying to inch in. There she is.
There she goes. That's a three-point shot. Mm-hmm. And miss, rebound by Chantel Williams.
Mm-hmm.
Pass off to Katisha Hyman to London Thompson in the paint for the easy.
London Thompson.
Set the baseline drive. Nice. I like that, not settling for the shot, seeing mm-hmm. as though DJ did just get a hand on the attempt. Broncos now on a 14-2 run.
Ball's out of bounds. Medium timeout. For all the up-to-date information about Fable State Athletics, visit the official.
All right, so we got about 3 minutes and 12 seconds of play when we come back from this break. We've got a message from Cheer 5 Smooth. We're going to enjoy that, and we'll be right back.
Let's hear it for Cheer 5 Smooth. D'Angelo Harris. D'Angelo Harris, please make your way to the scorer's table. D'Angelo Harris, please make your way to the scorer's table. We have your identification card. D'Angelo Harris, please make your way to the scorer's table. We have your identification card.
And we are back. Ariana Fleming goes for the drive.
Nice block.
And she was rejected by Aminata Johnson.
Oh, yeah.
Tyra at the top of the key with the ball. Kicks it to Ariana Fleming.
Ooh.
Ball almost stolen by Katisha Hyman. Swanson looking at the basket again, thinking about it. Kicks it back to Tyra. Tyra goes for the three-pointer. Miss again.
Nice rebound.
Kenyatta Cherry goes for the rebound. Miss ball brought up the court.
Ooh.
Aminata in the basket.
Yes. Nice feed from Hyman to Aminata. She actually gets fouled at the end one. Let's get it. 31-17 in the first half. I love it. Love to see it.
On the line shooting plus one for the Broncos, number 32, Aminata Johnson.
Aminata at the free throw line. Misses her first. I guess they thought she was getting two shots there.
Okay, nice little mix up. Definitely a mismatch. Oh! Popped out of the rim. But that was great for them to recognize that she had a smaller body on her. Victoria Swanson is definitely in no position to be able to guard a girl like Aminata Johnson.
No one, I don't believe, in the game right now can guard Aminata.
Right.
Chantel
in the corner.
Bennett in the corner. I mean, I'm sorry, Chantel Williams in the corner.
Top of the key, Williams to Aminata Johnson.
Nice. Aminata Johnson.
She's got Swanson pinned. It's really nothing you can do about that except get ready to try to get ready for the rebound if she misses it. Big if.
Swanson goes for the three. Doesn't get that. Aminata with the rebound. Passes to Chantel Williams to Chantel Bennett. Chantel Bennett loses it. London Thompson pick it up. Mm-hmm. And it's foul. Oh, no. They call the foul.
Number five, London Thompson. That's her first. Team first foul.
Team's first.
To the game for the Bears, number 25, Dominique Kennedy.
I'm not sure if this is a man-to-man defense or a full court press.
Swanson with the ball again. Kicks it to Cherry, to Tyra. Back to Cherry. Swanson. Cherry goes for the shot.
Ooh, air ball from Cherry. Williams rebound. Ooh, nice pass. Oh, nice finish. That was beautiful from Williams to Hyman. Nice bounce pass, threading the needle. Way to finish, Hyman.
Yeah, Cherry thought she was going to get a steal, but Pickens wasn't fast enough.
I got it.
That was a good one. Tyra at the top with the ball. Calling the play for the team.
She's calling for something to happen. Oh, missed three.
Rebound by Kennedy.
Swatted away from Williams. They are just.
Chantel Bennett missed the free throw.
Ooh, nice.
Hyman missed the free throw.
Layups.
I'm so sorry, guys.
Sorry. I had your back. She meant layups, guys.
I know the difference. Let's start there. I know the difference. I'm just very excited. This is a very good game. And the Broncos are playing amazing defense.
Mm-hmm. Tyra Colin Horn, Katisha Colin Horn, so you know that they've pretty much watched film and they know what's coming, so there it is. Cherry, not fast enough.
Violation. Possession goes to the Broncos.
Score is now 35-17. Shot clock violation, 6 minutes left to play. Oh, excuse me, 6 seconds.
Yeah, 6 seconds.
Oh,
yeah,
what was I talking
time
about?
There.
That's three for Katisha Hyman.
Wow.
At the end of the first
that
half.
That girl is automatic. We need to start calling her Bears Katisha Automatic 17. Hyman. All right, so we are going to go to the half. We've got about 15 minutes of a break. So, guys, if you are tuned in, please stay with us. We've got another two quarters of play for this conference game between the Fayetteville State University Broncos and Shaw University Bears. The Broncos lead 38-17. We'll be right back. Go grab yourself some popcorn and a Coca-Cola or something to drink. I'm Kiana Smith, and I'm with
Tashina Boo.
We'll be right back after this.
Okay, Broncos, we are at our halftime. So now we're about to play a game called Title IX Balloon Relay. So
So our two teams, we have Chris, Symphony, and Bryce. And our second team, Quavo, Maria, and Nyasia. Nyasia Stevens. To the floor. Quavo, Maria, and Nyasia.
First team is Chris, Symphony, and Bryce versus Quavo, Maria, and Nyasia Stevens. Is everybody? Okay, so let me explain the game. So, team one, team two, you have to get your balloon, go all the way down to the chair, pop it. After you pop it, you gotta come down, grab the ball, make a layup. Make sure you slap your partner's hand, the teammate's hand. Next person go, balloon, layup. Last person go, balloon, layup. And whoever is down here first wins, simply, okay? You ready, team one? Team two? We're gonna pop it first. Team one pops it first. We're gonna make the layup first. Uh-oh. We can't make the layup. All right, team one goes. Here goes Symphony.
Division II, student athletes leave a lasting impression.
Considering college or wanting to finish your degree, Fayetteville State University is proud to be your smart choice for a high-quality education, nationally ranked degree programs, and an exciting, supportive environment. You will receive an exceptional education at an affordable price. A part of the world-class University of North Carolina system, FSU is an incredible value and a great investment in your future. Visit uncfsu.edu/admissions to arrange a campus tour. We can't wait to meet you.
Spending time together sometimes means doing nothing at all. Holiday Inn, we're there so you can be too.
For the thirsty, for those who hang out in packs, for heroes, for sidekicks, for those who see the glass half empty, for those who see it half full, for those on the right, for those on the left, for those with nicknames, for those with curves, for people that cycle, for people that recycle, for BFFs, for frenemies, for those with style, for lovers, for families, for big families, for everyone.
Oh! No. Oh.
When you carry out, some things are out of your control. But with Domino's new carryout insurance, we'll replace your pizza if it gets ruined after you leave the store. Carry out large three-topping pizzas for $7.99 every day.
In NCAA Division II, student-athletes leave a lasting impression on their communities. That's because Division II student-athletes want to make a difference and truly be part of their surrounding communities. Through community engagement, thousands of student-athletes from various backgrounds interact with community members who view them as role models. This interaction leaves a positive and perhaps even life-changing impression on all those involved. In Division II, we rise to the opportunity and make community engagement ours.
Being a champion takes more than talent, more than the perfect pass, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the spirit to always push harder, the ability to overcome any hurdle, and the fire to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create. And the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
Hey Bronco fans, we really need your support. Please consider joining the 1000 Broncos campaign. 100% of your donation goes towards scholarships for deserving student athletes. You can join our campaign by visiting fsubroncos.com and click on Donate Now.
Visual on target. Target in sight. Convoy on route.
Hold the line, that's a good line, hold the line.
Sometimes the front lines are in our own backyard. Make a difference in your community, serving part-time in the Army National Guard.
Being a champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create, and the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
It's Domino's. I have to go.
Get that pizza.
I just ordered Domino's.
For this?
Yeah. Yeah. Thanks.
Order and track your pizza with Domino's Tracker.
Considering college?
Between the Fayetteville State University Broncos and Shaw University Bears. We're here at halftime. It's about 4.5 minutes left until we go into the third quarter of a play, but the Broncos are leading 38-17. We've been seeing a lot of great plays. We've got a lot of blocks. There's a number of Broncos right now on the roster that have blocked. Kasisha Hyman, you guys pretty much already know she has a pair of threes from behind the arc. We had Chantel Bennett with a lot of drives and layups. Also, London Thompson has drained a three from deep in the corner. So, honestly, the Bears haven't scored any more than 2 points since the first quarter. So, they're at a freeze pretty much. And like we talked about in the pregame, I'd expected to see the Broncos actually using this as an opportunity to go in on stats. And like we talked about, Aminata Johnson, she was just 2 rebounds shy of a double-double the last time when they played Johnson Smith. So there's no reason why none of the Broncos can go after, you know, any personal goals that they have for themselves as far as, you know, boxing out or making sure that you make X amount of rebounds or making sure that you get a double-double or a triple-double or whatever the case may be. How you feeling about the first half of play?
I'm feeling pretty good. Like I said, the Broncos definitely started to pick up on their rebounding towards the end of, towards the second quarter. They are becoming a threat behind the three-point line. So, again, this is a very, very good game. Broncos are playing great basketball. And the second half is going to be just as good, I'm sure.
Absolutely. Let me locate a stat sheet, and I'll be able to... And I'll be able to tell you guys exactly how many points everyone has for the first quarter. All right, so starting with the Broncos, I have Chantel Bennett leading the effort with 12 points. She's 5 of 6 from the field. She's 100% from behind the free throw line with a total of 3 rebounds. Behind her is Katisha Hyman. She has 10 points and 2 rebounds. She's 2 of 5 from the three-point line, 4 of 10 from the field. After that is London Thompson with 7 points, 4 total rebounds, 50% from behind the arc, 1 of 2 from the three-point line. And then following is Aminata Johnson with a total of 7 rebounds. She's actually 3 of 6 from the field. So they're doing an outstanding job. They have 22 total rebounds as a team, and the Shaw University Bears have 17. You can talk about what Shaw has as far as the stat sheet is concerned.
So as far as their leading scores, they have...
Leading the effort is Sydney Callis with 5 points. She's 1 of 2 from the three-point line, so she's shooting 50%. She's been to the free throw line twice. She's 100% from the free throw line. Behind her is Victoria Swanson with 3. She's made 1 3 out of 6 since the game started with 2 rebounds.
And
actually, DeJoria and Sydney are actually tied for 5 points, and DeJoria has 3 rebounds as well.
Yeah, and a real struggle point for the Bears is behind the three-point line. They are 3 and 14 for 3, so they've had over 14 attempts and only made 3 of those. Also, they're struggling from the field. They are 6 for 29. So, again, those are some struggles points. They're shooting 20% from the field and 21% from the three-point line as we start the second half of basketball. The Broncos do have the ball. And we are just waiting for some official business.
Beginning the second half, Broncos ball.
Ball is inbounded. Chantel Williams with the ball. Chantel Williams drives, shoots the basket, miss off the mark. London Thompson.
Nice.
Sorry, that's Chanel Davis coming off the bench, actually starting this game with the two-pointer. DJ can't hold on to the ball at half court. Kicks it to Katisha Hyman. Katisha Hyman drives to the basket, kicks it out to London Thompson for the basket. And Chantel Davis kicks it back out. Chantel Williams with the ball at the top. Kicks it to Chanel Davis.
Ooh, nice take.
Couldn't finish. DJ with the rebound for Shaw as Ariana Fleming brings the ball up the court. I'm sorry, that is Sydney Callis.
Almost another steal by Katisha Hyman. The pass from Fleming to Howard. Swanson's looking for a bear to get open. DJ's at the top of the key being guarded by Bennett. Swung to Fleming. She's going to drive and try to turn the corner. She finds Swanson. Swanson recognizes that the shot clock is winding down. She's asking for a foul now. She thought she got fouled on that last possession.
Okay, Broncos ball. Chantel Williams brings the ball up the court. Kicks it to London Thompson.
Ooh.
Back to Chantel for the basket and easy bucket.
You know what? I never noticed until right now that Chantel Williams is left-handed.
Oh.
I didn't know that. She is left-handed. Okay.
I'm sure she can go to her right as well.
Mm-hmm.
Sure she is.
Callis finds Fleming on the opposite wing. DJ is going to swing it back. Callis in the corner. She's going to take the baseline. Swatted away by Chantel Williams.
Chantel Bennett drives all the way to the basket for the easy bucket. Now, DJ had about three fouls before the end of the first half, so she's definitely playing a little timid with not causing the foul. Ball stays with the Bears.
Callis looking for something. She finds Swatson. Back to Callis. Uh-oh, trying to get it to DJ. Katisha Hyman was there. Katisha Hyman to London Thompson. Off balance. Still makes the basket.
Very good control. Sydney Callis brings the ball up the court for the Bears. Ariana Fleming calling for a pick. And DJ for the two-pointer.
Hyman working Fleming on the wing.
In
the hollow block, it looks like Hyman might have been poked in the eye. I want to say something similar happened like that last game as well.
Yeah.
And Jada's going to come in to make sure she is situated. I'm not sure if she wears contacts or not, but. Or was it the men's game? Remember Jalen Seager lost the contact?
Oh, yeah, that was the contact last game, yeah.
Bennett rolling off of the rotation. She's going to take a stab at a three.
And Chantel Williams.
Chantel Williams finds it. Lucky left-handed Chantel Williams. I can't believe I didn't notice that until just now.
That's three for
Victoria Swanson. Gets a three to drop. But Sydney Callis cannot hold on to the ball. Ball is going to the Broncos. Chantel Bennett with the ball.
Back to Chantel. Chanel's cutting. She finds her. Hits Bennett. Chantel's in the corner. Still throws it up, and it's still good.
Bears inbound the ball. Swanson to Callis. Callis to number 25, Kennedy. In the paint to DJ. DJ with the two-pointer. Chantel Williams with the ball. Passes it to Faison.
Ooh, nice.
Faison kicks it to
London.
London with the shot is short. She gets her own rebound.
Yep.
Back to Chantel Bennett for another three.
Oh.
In and out. And Callis brings the ball up to up the court for the Bears. Kicks it to Swanson. Swanson with the jumper and bucket. The score is now 52-26. Broncos leading the way with 4 minutes and 46 seconds left in the third quarter.
Oh, nice cut from Chantel Bennett. London Thompson caught her right outside the lane. Oh.
Too strong. Rebound by Sydney Callis. Bringing the ball up the court for the Bears. Pass to Swanson. Swanson kicks it back to Sydney Callis at the top of the key. Screen set by DJ. Back to Swanson. Swanson drives in. Missed. Rebound by the Bears.
Oh, another block from Chantel Williams.
DJ at the top with the ball. And
Callis
drives and draws the foul.
I'm surprised she even got that off her hands. Chantel Williams there getting ready to deny anything going up to the basket.
Yes, absolutely. So Broncos are playing great basketball. Media timeout here. And we will be back shortly. Money like a free throw. You just keep on dancing like a freak. Arch your back, put your hands on your knees. Bounce that out, come on. Bounce that out. Yeah, for this cash, yeah. Can you make it clap, yeah, for a stack, yeah. I wanna see you twerk, yeah, put in work, yeah. Take off your shirt, yeah, go berserk, yeah. Split on a duke, yeah, do a trick, yeah. Yo, hey, yeah, full of, yeah. Baddest in the party, yeah, pop them, yeah. Got a lot of body, yeah, la-di-da-di, yeah. With no lanes, yeah, playing games, yeah. I be switching lanes, yeah, make it rain, yeah. I be stunting hard, yeah, in the mall, yeah. Riding foreign cars, yeah, I'm a star, yeah.
All
right, Sydney Callis is at the free throw line to shoot her and one shot. Mm. And she makes her free throw.
Mm-hmm.
The score is now 52-29 with 4 minutes left in the third quarter.
Mm-hmm.
And they're going to call a foul on the floor.
Biggest foul on number two, DJ Holler. That's their second.
And that is actually DJ's second foul of the game.
Ooh, nice feed to Aminata Johnson, who has DJ posted up. Oof. Shouldn't have missed that. It's going to be DJ Howard's rebound. Callis carrying the ball across half court for the Bears. Finds Victoria Swanson. DJ Howard there to swing the ball over to Callis. Kennedy back to Howard. It's a lot of ball movement. It's on the wing in Kennedy's hands, and she travels. It's going to be Broncos basketball. Chantel, quarterbacking this thing, telling the Broncos what she wants out of this possession here. It's a screen from Aminata Johnson. Kick out to Jada on the baseline. Aminata at the elbow. Off the backboard. It's too hard. It's going to be Howard's rebound. She finds Callis. Callis eyes up. She want to give it to Swanson so bad. She'll set up for Kennedy. Kennedy gives it to Swanson in the corner. Bring it back up to the wing. DJ Howard. doesn't even fully face up. She gives it up to Callis. A couple passes between those two. Cherry to DJ. In and out of the rim. Rebound by Williams.
Williams bringing the ball to the court for the Broncos. Slows it down. Passes the ball off to London Thompson. London Thompson's calling the play for the Broncos. Drives the ball in behind the three-point line. Drives it all the way in, and no one picks her up. Easy basket for London Thompson.
I mean, like, 1, 2, 3, ABC. I love to see it.
Basketball by the sophomore.
Oh, yeah. Great call by the vet. Chantel Williams is one that called the motion play and left the ball in the hands of London. So that's trust. That's confidence in your teammates. And then that's just reading the defense. DJ Howard with a three attempt. It's good.
Yes.
You know, they're playing very calm to be trailing by so much. At this point, they're trailing by 22 points. It's 54-32. Drive down the baseline by Jada. Kick it out to Aminata Johnson again. In and out of the rim.
Sydney brings the ball up the court. Passes it off to Kennedy. Calls for DJ, kicks it back to Sydney in the paint for Kennedy, who wasn't quite ready. Back to DJ at the three-point. Missed three-pointer by DJ. Ball up the court by Katisha Hyman. Waits for her teammates. Kicks it to
Jada.
Jada and Chantel Williams with the ball behind the three-point. Kicks it to Aminata Johnson in the paint. Goes up.
Didn't move, but I just need her to finish. That is three possessions now. That could have been six extra points for her. She would be sitting at 12 points and 7 rebounds.
Sydney Callis calling the ball for the Bears. Kennedy with the shot. And lucky bounce there for her.
She got the bounce in the rim. Okay, good job, Jada. There was a no-look pass from... Ooh! It's her second charge of the game. She picked up her first one in the first quarter. I think she just has her mind already made up of what she's going to do. Yeah. Good thing that it's not crunch time or anything like that happening. All right, we got Swanson carrying the ball. She's going to carry it across half court. Give it up to Callis.
2 seconds left on the clock.
Nice shot by Kennedy.
And the end of three, 54. Bears 37.
All right, so we've got a couple of minutes to regroup and regather before we go into the last quarter of play in this conference game here in the Felton. Jay Capel Arena, known as the Capel, Shaw University and Fayetteville State, Chair 5, giving us a little cheer fun. And we'll be right back after this.
DJ Fudge.
Beginning the fourth quarter.
Baseball.
All right, ball is inbounded by Swanson to Sydney Callis. Back to Swanson at the top of the 3-point.
Start of the fourth quarter, and the possession is the Bears. They've actually got a lot to chip away at Callis. attempts a three. It's blocked by Bennett. Broncos back off to the races.
Bears coming with a little bit of ball pressure.
Screen from Williams for London. Oh, Aminata working hard in the paint, just unable to get anything to fall for. I think she's missed about four shots now, but she gets fouled on that attempt. So she'll actually go to the free throw line.
On the line with two shots for the Broncos, number 32, Aminata Johnson.
So Bennett talking to the ref. There was
Bears foul number 14,
okay. There was actually a foul, so it's going to be on the floor, and the foul was by Victoria Swanson. It's going to be it's going to remain under the Broncos basket. London finds Bennett. Hook shot for Bennett. She has a lot in her arsenal.
She does. She does. Very versatile.
Creative.
Swanson with the ball, deciding what she wants to do with it. DJ posts up. She kicks it to Kennedy for the three-pointer, and she gets it to fall.
Kennedy motioning for them to come on, so I think that she's fired up and motivated to try to chip away at this 16-point lead that the Broncos have set.
And the Bears are doing a pretty good job talking on defense, making sure their communication is there. But let's see if it's enough.
Rebound by Kennedy, passed off to Callis.
Back to Sydney, back to Kennedy.
Ooh,
and
deep.
Kennedy is a three-point shooter, but she misses that one.
Rebound by Aminata Johnson. London Thompson will carry it up. Find Katisha Hyman. I tried to remix Hyman and Thompson.
Trying to do a hybrid player there.
They got to feed Aminata. It's too much. Aminata's looking at the ref as if she wanted a foul from DJ. Callis to Kennedy. Kennedy to DJ on the baseline. Skip pass to Swanson.
That was a good fake pass by Swanson.
We're going to
call a foul on
Katisha. That's her second team first of the fourth quarter. Substitution into the game for the Broncos, number 15, Chanel Davis.
Kennedy gets the inbound pass. She's actually going to drive it in. London Thompson with the defensive board finds Hyman. Hyman to Bennett. And Kennedy again takes the ball out of bounds. She's trying to get everybody motivated and fired up. Kennedy actually ended the half with 2 points and two total rebounds. Swung around the
Katisha Hyman
the
with
horn.
The three.
Three. Well,
nothing but the bottom of the net. Bears with the ball. Swanson at the side of the three-point line. Kicks it back to Sydney Callis.
Callis and Swanson. That's
across the court to out of bounds.
Almost out of bounds. Possession remains to the Bears.
Yes, that was almost a steal by Williams. Except she found the hardwood. It's actually a very high pass. Inbound to Kennedy. Callis cutting through. Finds DJ. guarded by Chanel.
DJ Howard.
It's good for Howard.
Media timeout.
Score is now 59-40 Broncos. Still ahead by a lot. Oh, excuse me, 59-42. But I mean, the Broncos still have a lot of room to play with. So we're gonna go to the media timeout. We'll be right back after this.
Title IX. We pledge to take a stand Let's against go. All forms of sexual harassment you know and sexual violence. We prohibit gender discrimination in all educational and athletic activities. Visit our Title IX table and take the pledge today.
From the timeout, the Broncos' possession is inbounded from London. Bennett and back to London. She's going to carry the ball over the half-court line, presumably for the Broncos. She's being guarded by Callis. It looks like the Bears are now in a man-to-man defense. On the wing, she gets a screen from Chantel Williams. Aminata Johnson to Chantel Bennett. She's going to curl the elbow. Passed off to Katisha Hyman, where she was fouled by Keontae Sherry. It's going to be on the floor, and it's going to be under the Broncos' basket and inbound opportunity. Again, it's being inbounded by London Thompson. Hyman's going to keep it. Kick ball, but that was a good read from Katisha to Aminata. I love that they're like still feeding her even though she's not finishing, and that's just like another motivation, another way to motivate your team. Ooh, nice fadeaway jumper from Chantel Williams. But that's just another way to motivate your teammate and get her in the game, you know, because she is definitely a very impactful player, and she adds a lot to the roster still. From London Thompson, she finds Chantel Williams. Oh, she finds Chantel Williams. Williams the Hyman, and it slips through her hands and it's out of bounds. Basketball carried by Callis.
Yes, Callis bringing the ball up the court. Has Chantel Bennett guarding her. Kennedy with the ball, kicks it back to Callis. DJ calling for the ball. Kennedy wants to go for the shot. She kicks it to Jennifer Swanson for the three-pointer, and Jennifer gets a three-pointer. Victoria Swanson. Swanson has been going for that three-pointer all game long. She got her one to fall there.
I think that's her second one.
Cherry guarding. Ooh, and Aminata in the paint.
Nice.
Great cut and finished by Aminata Johnson. Sydney Callis with the ball, lets Kennedy know she's giving it off to her. Kennedy passes it back to Sydney Callis.
Kennedy giving it up, even though she in her sweet spot. Okay, there it goes.
Kennedy.
Did I get a chance to tell you guys about my thoughts last play when she had that ball? Yeah, she was in her spot.
What was that?
I was gonna say that it looked like a travel that time, so I'm glad that they caught her on that one. I mean, you know, 45-63 though. We got about 4 minutes and 42 seconds left to play here in the fourth quarter of the conference matchup here in the Cape. We'll be right back after this.
With me, I'ma flow through the city sipping on some Chardonnay. And I'ma buying out the bar today. And I'm buying out Barney's, yeah. I'ma hang with the gangbangers, you only hang with the feds and the rats and the mice. Get my young pull it with the bitch, I'ma pull it with the. We gon' get them on sight. We gon' make a thriller like Mike. Car candy painted Mike at night. And my diamonds looking like a light. I'ma fly private.
From court to court and lane to lane, under the lights or under the sun. No one delivers Division II sports like NCAA.com. The center of D2 is inside the NCAA.com hub. With exclusive highlights of every sport and live broadcasts of every Division II championship, found nowhere else. Make NCAA.com yours. The home of Division II college sports.
We can stop to make sure someone is.
All right, and we are back. The Broncos have the ball. Linda Thompson is going to inbound it to Katisha Hyman. Katisha Hyman brings the ball up the court. Katisha Hyman gives the ball off to Chantel Bennett. Aminata with the screen. Chantel Bennett with the jumper in and out. Linda Thompson
nice rebound,
with the
baby.
Rebound and foul. Called on the Shaw University Bears.
Nice rebound by Linda.
Bears foul number 11, Cindy Callis.
Gonna earn her a trip.
That's her first.
Strike.
Team four.
Yes, that foul was on Cindy Callis.
With two shots for the Broncos.
That was her first foul. Team's fourth foul. Thompson at the free throw line, in and out. And Thompson makes the second one. Sydney Callis brings the ball up the court for Shaw University. She kicks it off to Swanson. Kicks it back to Callis. And Kennedy is just waiting in the corner for the shot. DJ with the three-pointer.
That's three for
I believe DJ has a sweet spot all around the three-point line. The score is now 64-48, Broncos leading the way. And almost a steal by Cherry. Katisha Hyman with the ball, kicks it to Aminata. Aminata passes it off to London Thompson. London Thompson drives, kicks it back to Aminata for the jumper, and it is short. Tip rebound by London Thompson, kicks it to Chantel Williams.
She knows her strengths, right? London knows that she likely can't out jump all of them, but if she could just tip the basketball and get it back to where she knows she can get it,
yes,
she'll take that too.
And
straight
that
to the paint from the sideline.
Traveling. Possession goes to the Bears.
That was called a travel on Aminata Johnson. Now, before that, I know some of you were trying to figure out why the game was stopped. It's because it was a shot clock confusion
violation
there. They needed to, not a violation, just needed to put 17 seconds back on the clock. They put a fresh 30 on there, I believe. All right, Sydney Callis with the ball, drives into the paint and draws the foul on Aminata.
Bronco foul on number 32.
All right, Sydney Callis is at the free throw line. And Sydney Callis will be shooting three. I'm two. I'm so sorry, guys. Please forgive me today. It's been a bit exciting game. Sydney Callis will be shooting two. She missed her first free throw. And she makes her second free throw. And a timeout is going to be called by the Bears. And we have 3:26 left in the game. The score is 64 Broncos, 49 Bears. How are you feeling, Kiana? I mean, you know, I think the Broncos definitely came out ready to play for the second half of this ball game. How are you feeling about this game?
I'm feeling pretty good about it. I figured that it would be a W for them. And just another hash mark on their winning streak with Virginia State and Johnson Smith University. I'm glad that they get to play ahead and they get to play their game and just continue to see players like Amanada Johnson, let Chanel Davis start and get good touches and good looks. And same for London Thompson and Chantel Williams is lighting things up from behind the arc. So I felt like this would be a great game for them to kind of establish some new marks for themselves as far as stats were concerned.
Looked like Swanson stepped out of bounds there. I think they missed that call. Oh.
Glad that she wasn't hurt or injured with that last one.
Sydney Callis from 3 point gets that 3-pointer to drop.
Chantel Williams being guarded by Kennedy. Then they give it off to Chantel Bennings and a drive in, kick it out to Hyman, who's on the wing. She takes a screen from Amanada Johnson. A little bit off the mark. It's a rebound for London Thompson. She's going to carry it out. Looks like the Broncos are going to try to milk the clock at this point. The Bears aren't that far away from the 64-52. I believe that if they were, you know, very motivated, they could possibly get, oh, nice. Nice teardropper from Williams. But if they were motivated, they could possibly cut down, or they probably, if they would have started early in the third quarter.
Or if they would have got this stop, too, I think they would have had that last, I think, they, you know what I mean? If they would have stopped that last basket, I think they would have had a better chance of coming back. Mm-hmm. But again, the Bears are playing with very great composure for them to
nice.
Be down. Sydney Callis pops down to three. They do. They absolutely do.
They're only down 11 right now. So they're probably going to have to foul because, I mean, based off of that last possession, the Broncos are using all 30 seconds of their possession. Hyman feeds Amanada, finds London. It's about 12 seconds left on the shot clock. Chantel Bennett back to Amanada. Good for the layup.
And now we are... with 1 minute left in the game.
Ball's out of bounds. The possession remains to the Bears.
All right, Broncos with the steal. Katisha Hyman down the court, going up against Kennedy.
Ooh,
kicks
no look.
It back to
Bennett.
Chantel Bennett. Now Chantel Williams have the ball at the top. Kennedy guarding her. She's letting this clock run out.
Oh, yeah. Great defense by Kennedy, though.
It is.
She's been playing great defense all game. I do want to highlight that. Stop and pop from Hyman.
And get offensive rebound by Chantel Bennett. Williams, excuse me. And the Broncos are going to run that clock out. And that is the ball game.
All right, scores now 68-55. The Broncos have... came out victorious over the Broncos.
Always ready, always there. The National Guard continues its historic dual mission, providing trained units to the state's territories and the District of Columbia and even
The Guard also provides trained units to the nation equipped and ready to defend the United States and its interests all over the globe. Visit www.nationalguard.com for more information on the National Guard. Good night from Capel Arena.
Fresh out of high school, kicked out the house for living fast. When he got a spot, then got a job, cause pops was on my end. south, east, west. Hold up, bruh. The only way I'm going is the fudge way. It's your girl, D. Renee. Let's get it.
All right, so Coach, you just got done beating the Shaw University Bears 68-55. Let me hear some of your initial thoughts about today's game and how you feel.
We started the game a little slow, but second quarter we locked them down defensively. And I think we got to relax too much coming out of the half, and they started to get hot. But we still finished the game strong, so I'm pleased with it.
Okay, so you had a little bit of a mix-up with the starting lineup when we had Chanel Davis come out. Talk about what she's been doing to improve and how practices have been going to be able to give her that start tonight.
Well, Chanel's been working hard. We're trying to gain her some confidence. And when she looked better in the second half, she probably was a little bit nervous. But we gotta get more out of our younger players, and so that's why she got that opportunity tonight.
Absolutely. So I want to hear about just some mix-up as far as court is concerned. We had Chantel Williams with a very big game. Aminata Johnson got a lot of touches. So just talk about how this will, what this will do for the rest of the season.
I mean, they're going to get those looks, we hope, the rest of the season. But when they can get those touches, it's about recognizing what the defense gives us. When the defense gives us those opportunities, we're supposed to take full advantage of them. And that's what they did. They took what the defense gave them, and they were able to capitalize on them tonight.
Absolutely. Well, congratulations, Coach. We'll hear more from you in the postgame.
All right. Thank you so much.
Alrighty, so I just got done talking with head coach Serena King Coleman with the victory over the Shaw University Bears 68-55. I'm going to send it back to Tashina.
All right, and we are back with the post game results. So again, Fayetteville State with 68, Shaw University with 55, and our leading scorer for the game is Chantel Bennett with 16 points. She was 2 for 2 for the free throw, from the free throw line. Also, we have Chantel Williams with a total of 15 points, who shot 6 for 15 total field paint points. Also, we had London Thomas, who has a total of 12 points. She had a total of 10 rebounds, and she shot 5 for 9 from the field today. The Broncos played an amazing game with great defense. A total of 6 steals for the game, 12 total turnovers, and only 1 block for the game. Again, the Broncos have defeated the Shaw Bears 68-55. And thank you guys for coming out.